Bring your attention to your body. Bring your attention to your body sensations. And right away, we'll examine this. Notice the part of bringing your attention to your body sensations that you did, and the part that I did for you by telling you to do it. Notice the part of bringing your attention to your body sensations that you did, and the part that I did by saying, bring your attention to your body sensations. Attempt to see this clearly. And you can do it again and again. Once again, bring your attention to your body sensations. Well, you did some of that, but I also told you, do it again and again. So you could say that I did some of it for you. An attempt to clearly see the part of it that I did and the part of it that you did. I am one of the teachers at the Monastic Academy, but another teacher, Peter, and I sometimes talk about people coming to us for instruction. And he says that the basic attitude that people bring is, okay, make me enlightened. Okay, make me enlightened. Quickly make it so that I am enlightened. Well, now you can examine that process. I just told you. I just made you concentrate, yes? I said, focus on body sensations. And then you did something. Please carefully look at that process. It's important to know that while Peter's point is that it's inappropriate to go to someone and tell them, make me enlightened, he is not saying that one person cannot help another. He's not saying that the teacher-student relationship is meaningless. If he were saying that, then of course he's a hypocrite. But he's not saying that. One person can help another. Teaching does have value. And why? Because your teacher cannot do the work for you. That's why the teacher has value. And you can explore this right now. I'm supporting you in your practice, but you have to do it. Pay attention to the part that I'm doing and the part that you're doing. The part that you're doing is the part that saves the world. So, now, focus on your breath. And once again, notice precisely what you did when you focused on your breath. And notice the part that I did when I told you to. Focus on your inhalations and your exhalations, breathing in and breathing out. Notice how inhaling feels, how exhaling feels. Notice that you can do that. The act of doing that, isn't there joy there? Is that not a miracle? if you are distracted, if you're lost in thinking, for example, return your attention to your breath. Notice again, you did that. I told you to. That's the miracle of instruction. You did it. That's the miracle of the path. The only person who could turn your attention from the thought you were lost in to your breath is you. That's your special power. No one else can purify the world in that way. You're the only one who was lost in that thought. So you're the only one who can purify that attachment. And isn't there joy in using your power? It's because of that miracle that there is the miracle of instruction. Instruction is a miracle within the context of that miracle. So once again, examine. What am I doing in telling you focus on your breath? What are you doing as you drop attachment and establish mindfulness of breathing? Once again, if you get distracted, return your attention to your breath. Once again, notice you are the one who got distracted in that particular way at this moment. So you are the one, the only one, who can purify that attachment, that distraction. And you are the one who is capable of that, who has the privilege, the honor of doing that right now. You are the primary beneficiary, you could say, of the purification of that suffering from the world. You're the first person who gets to experience the happiness of being free in this particular way. And you get to experience that purification of the world that you yourself embodied. Within that, within understanding of that, it makes sense that somebody set up this space for you and gave you a chair and instruction and the other miracles of teaching. But the miracle of teaching is a miracle because it's possible for someone else to do work that enables you to do the work that only you can do. Once again, if you happen to get lost in thought, if you're distracted in some other way, bring your attention back to your breath. Keep your attention on your breath, the sensations of inhaling and exhaling. And notice that when you do that, you are the one who did that. No one else could clarify, purify your mind as you brought your attention from that thought to your breath, for example, because you're the one who has that point of contact. You're the one who got distracted in that way at that time. And you're the one who can overcome that and purify your mind. So you're the one who can purify the world of that obstruction. If you understand that, then the miracle of instruction is a miracle, then I can tell you to do it. And it enables you to do it. So, having cultivated this way of looking at it, let's try to meditate with a different way of looking at it. Bring up the view, bring up the expectation, bring up the demand. Make me enlightened. Do the work for me. I came all the way here this evening. I did my part. Now, make me enlightened. It's not my job to concentrate, not my job to let go. do it for me. You can ask me or anyone to do that for you. Hold that perspective, hold that request. Make me enlightened. And to that, I would say, you can see, you can hear, you can feel. You cannot see, you cannot hear, you cannot feel. And if that was effective for you, very good. You're welcome. And yet you yourself made that request. And if you surrendered to it, you yourself surrendered to receiving that instruction. And if you didn't make that request, then you yourself didn't make that request. If you didn't surrender to it, then you yourself didn't surrender to it. Now, move into this practice with the attitude not that you need to be made to be enlightened, but that you have the opportunity right now to purify this moment of attachment and delusion. If you approach this with that attitude, the specific attachment and delusion that's arising for you right now is what you have the opportunity to purify. That's your service to the world. That's your point of contact. That's your opportunity. That's your miraculous ability. Then the teacher can move into that like a fish moves into water. If there's the sense, you do it for me, I can't do that, I shouldn't do that, then that's like a fish out of water. And a fish out of water is loud and obvious, bouncing around here and there on the bank. Vibrant force. But it's not a, you could say, a natural situation. The fish in water is very difficult to find at all. Goes back into the water and it's just gone. It's hard to say what it's doing. But that's its natural place. So hold the awareness that you can do this right now. Of course, there's the miracle of instruction. I can tell you to focus on your breath. But then, what is it that actually draws your attention from the distraction to your breath? Please find that water and wade in it. And splash around in it and enjoy it and rejoice. Rejoice in that activity. It extends throughout the universe. It's not your own.